Alrighty, today at powerjackrepair.org, I got ASUS Q504U. If you decide to call us for any reason, please send us an email or text, because no time to talk on the phone. This is a T5 connection, T5 Torx 5 screwdriver head, which we're gonna use to unscrew. I'm not sure if there are screws under this and that, but I will see in a second. Maybe we'll have to take them out. All right. Some of those laptops not even gonna power up after the repair because they have aluminum casing, and sometimes the aluminum casing shorts the motherboard. So we will replace this jack. It might work, might not work, go figure. I mean, if the client had to wiggle jiggle the plug to make the system work, then it's the jack. If the client never had to wiggle anything, then it's probably a shortage on the motherboard caused by the aluminum casing. Okay, so we got a screw here and we got the screw here as well. All right, those are just for the... All right. Feel free to send us just the motherboard. It's gonna be cheaper if you send us just the motherboard. All right. And again, this is for powerjackrepair.org, not the usbcrepair.com. So here, let's see if we can. I want to find a ledge someplace that's. Oh shoot! It's still powering up. Let me shut this thing down. Is there a way to shut this thing down? Well, not really. All right, Bruce. Shut down. Yeah, you want the whole thing to be completely off. Well, the good thing, it still works. So if it still works sometimes, that means it's gonna be it's gonna work after the repair, because nobody else screwed around with it. So, and it doesn't want to be shutting down. Okay. Come on. Down. Please shut down. Please, please, please. Still on. I wonder if this is a solid state drive in this, because it got an i5 7th generation, but some people just don't put solid state disk for some reason, even though solid state disk is what speeds everything up. The regular drives is the weakest point in any laptop. So if you don't have a solid state drive, I would highly encourage you to put one in, and everything is going to be working much, much faster. No, I can't even get anything anywhere here. Let's see if you can get something sharper. You know what, hold on. How about here? Nope. The clamp is pretty good. All right, so here, let's get in here. Come on. I wonder if my guitar pick just broke. All right, so come on, go in there. Yep. Come on. Okay, good job. Wonderful. Alrighty. Let's get everything out. Two screws, probably the ones that prohibited the workings of the laptops. The jack looks okay. I will replace it anyway. and then I replace the plug because those tips, they have tendencies to go out all the time. So here, no, the good thing, the laptop is working still. I wonder if I had this one already recorded before. Alright, so here's this one. This goes out like that. Lift up. Here. Let me show you what I'm doing. So here, this one goes up. Move that out of the way. This one goes up, lift it up, 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 and out. Alright, and here we got this guy. This guy, remove those two. And here, just kind of like that. Alright. Alright, the screws right there. Like that. Oops. Alright, so remove this. And we got one screw, two screws. One and two. And three right there. Alright, so they're all the same. Okay. Okay. And that's how we got the motherboard out. If you want, you can send it as the motherboard and we can replace the jack on it. Let me go find compatible jack. The jack should be for sale at the link below. My favorite scissors. So the captain tape is used to insulate the area around the jack, so that the nearby components won't be falling off while I'm desoldering the jack. Alright. And alrighty. Like that. Now, I don't use any foil here because there's not that many smaller components that are prone to coming out of the motherboard. I'm just using captain tape without any foil. So good. Now this is a top side, so I have to mark it as top. Top. Okay. Okay, this sharp is really stinky. Alrighty. So I'm gonna add the flux, I'm gonna add some solder, some hot air, and it's gonna pop off the motherboard. Alright, here. Alrighty. Alrighty, let's see if it's gonna be conducting the electricity to the board. Alright, so minus is fine. Plus is fine as well. Yeah, okay. So minus and pluses are fine, so let's put it all back together. And I will replace the plug. Alrighty. Now the jack sits slightly higher than needs to be. My guess, I need to trim the casing a little bit so that the holes would align. And instead of trimming, what I usually do is I just... It's gonna be slightly a few more millimeters higher, but I don't want the people to break the connection in there. That's the one. Like that. Good job. Let me double check that. Nope, slightly not 5%. Okay, good job. Okay. Need to get the extra metal out of the casing so it wouldn't be shorting the motherboard. Okay, so we got three cables here, one right there. And we park it somewhere like that. Like that. Good? Good, wonderful. Yeah, looks fine. Yeah, looks really good. This thing gonna close down just fine. Yep, okay. Wonderful. Hopefully the top of the jack won't be sticking out. It wouldn't be shorting the motherboard in any way, shape or form. Okay. Alright. Alright, let's tighten up. Just making sure that the screws are tightened up enough. Let's connect the cables here. Alright, so first we connect this guy. Like that. Close that. Like that. I wonder if all of the cables were inside of this ledge. Okay. Alrighty. Now we connect this guy and this guy here. Alright, good job. Okay, that's good. You have to have your edges in there, like that, all right. Okay, looks like everything's connected. No, screw right there. Alright. Yep, let's turn it over, make sure nothing is gonna flank all over the place. Alright, let's connect the hard drive, the battery. Now let's the cover on. Alright, once I put the cover on. I apologize, people interrupting all the time. Guys, if you decide to call us, you know, text us first. Text or email us. Because, oh, you know what, hold on. I'm afraid that this thing is too high here. And it's gonna be sitting right on top of the jack. This guy. So what I need to do is cut this guy out. Like that. It's just 1 or 2 millimeters difference, but I need. I have to make it work, guys. And this is. I checked all of the China. There is no exactly the same jack out there. What we sell is exactly the one that we put in. And that's the reason why here. Oh, and I also need to put some tape on top because that plus might be touching the. Hopefully, the plastic doesn't conduct electricity. This particular plastic. Okay, so like that. Let's see if this is conducting anything. So, oh wow, it does not conduct electricity. Wow, that's the first thing. Wow, 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 wow. It's such a pain that doesn't conduct electricity. All right. Closing down here. Slide, well, there's no gap really. Everything's gonna be fine. Here, let me screw in this guy. Alright, and let's screw in that guy. Let's put those two guys right there where they belong, right there. Well, let's see. Nope, no gap. Everything's fine. You see? No gap. Okay, now let's screw this whole thing in. Like that. Need to get a new set of those fights because this guy is already worn out after a year. Good job. All right, so we got the red light right there. And I mean, it was working when we received it. Just want to make sure that it's going to show me that it's charging. One day I'm gonna buy a sailboat and sail away. Hopefully. Away from all those. Away from computers. Still waiting for it to load up. Again, this is not a solid state drive for sure. This is just a regular drive, and why would you put not a solid state drive in? It's beyond me. I mean, you pay for the i5 7th generation, you might as well put the solid state drive in. Come on. Come on. Oh. Alright, let me pause this thing because. Alright, let's see. You see right there, it shows that it's plugged in and charging. So we're all good. Thank you so much for watching. And you guys leave a like. Have a good day. Thank you.